All right, number 39, very similar to what you just had with the burglar. Only this time we are more humane, and this is more like Mary Poppins Feed the Birds. I'm not going to sing and torture you. 150 newtons. Again, this is not mass, this is already force of gravity, aka weight. So if I were to show it, it's going like that, showing that on the bird feeder. And then the bird feeder would be supported vertically with the tension in the upward cable, and it would be equal to 150 newtons, according to Newton's first law, because our bird feeder is in equilibrium, and therefore it's not moving up or down, or if it were moving, it would be moving with a constant velocity, not accelerating. We need to find tension in each cable. Again, this right here would experience 150, so vertical cable, right and left. That's what I'm gonna distinguish them by. And vertical tension equals 150 newtons. Now the two cables are both at an angle now, and tension is along those two cables. So this is, I'm going to say tension right y, tension right x. Then this right here would be another tension, and that would be tension left. And if we split it into x and y components again, this will be left. Left. Enough already. Left y and left x. Now, the thing about these forces, the vertical was very easy. The two at an angle will require a little bit of work. So if I look at my x and y components, so left and right, left, x and y component. So for left, I would have to do left. If this is 60 degrees, then that is 60 degrees. So it's going to be left cosine of 60, left sine of 60 for vertical. For the right cable, same idea. This is 30 degrees right here. Therefore, I'm going to say right cosine of 30, and then right sine of 30. Now, the thing is, horizontally, I technically have to say that this is negative because it's pulling to the left. And horizontally, my diagram is not quite true because it shows like my vector on the right, its x component is longer than the vector on the left and its x component. To make them equal to each other, I'm going to redraw this and adjust it accordingly, because in order for this to be in equilibrium, the force on the right should have the same x component as the force on the left, right there. So now they're more like it. So this is going to be my right vector. And now we can work with the idea that the x components of these two add up to zero, and therefore I can say, rewrite them as right cosine of 60 equals left. Sorry. What am I doing? I marked the wrong ones. Mark the x and y component of the same vector. Big mistake! Never do that. I'm looking at these. So they add up to zero because the x component is zero for our net force. Now I'm going to write them correctly. So L cosine of 60 will be equal to R cosine of 30. Okay, So then, if I were to substitute them later on, I can just express L equals R cosine of 30 divided by cosine of 60. Now, the beauty of it is cosine of 60 is 1/2. Dividing by 1/2 is kind of like multiplying by 2. So I'm going to say L is 2R cosine of 30. Boom. So this will later serve me for substitution. Now let's look at vertical. Vertically, these two guys put together should counteract the weight of the bird feeder and be equal to, put together, to 150 newtons. So I'm going to say L sine of 60 plus R sine of 30 equals 150 newtons. So I'm going to say L sine of 60 plus R over 2 equals 150 newtons, because I know that sine of 30 is half. Instead of a left, I'm going to use the 2R cosine of 30. So 2R cosine of 30, sine of 60, the beauty of it, it's the same thing, plus R over 2 equals 150 newtons. After this, sine of 60 and cosine of 30 is the same thing, so I can say 2R cosine of 30 squared plus R over 2 equals 150 newtons. After this, you can say that it's just, if I multiply everything by 2, that's 4R cosine squared of 30 degrees plus R plus, equals 300 newtons. And then you have R times 4 cosine squared of 30 plus 1 equals 300 newtons. Then so you have just R equals 300 over 4 cosine squared of 30 plus 1. So plug that into your calculator and figure it out. You could have stopped somewhere and calculated what cosine times sine equals and whatnot. Ultimately, we only have in this equation, we only have one variable, which is R. That's the force in the right cable or in the right rope. And so as soon as we established this part, physics ended and we just started algebra, but you need to know both. So there we go. I'm going to pause and calculate. All right, so having plugged it into the calculator, the cable or the rope on the right is producing a 75 newton tension in it by supporting the weight of our bird feeder at 30 degrees. And now to figure out the force on the left, you can grab this substitution right here. So left is going to be 2, 75 cosine of 30, so 150 cosine of 30 degrees, 150 times cosine of 30 degrees. This is going to give me a lot of pain right now. 150 cosine of 30 degrees gives us 130 newtons. So here are your answers. We have 150 going this way, 75, and 130 newtons going that way. When you draw them, this left X and right X balance each other out. Left Y and RY, the two vertical components, LY plus RY, together add up to 150 newtons, and LR and LX equals RX, and they're opposite each other. That's why technically I would say LX plus RX equals zero. So they're opposite and equal. That's it.